Good evening. I am Anaya Hernandez, head technician for the HHS Drama Club, and I'd like to present to you 10 ways to survive the zombie apocalypse. Tonight, we will be transporting you to an apocalyptic era. This play is directed by Natalie Galán, Gabriel Rodriguez, and Erica Iñas as they hope to convey to the audience the comedic yet frightening trials and tribulations faced during an eerie zombie-ridden world. If you have an emergency or someone to contact, please do so outside. There should also be no flash photography or filming of the scenes. We don't want to blind our actors or us in the lecture room. Please be quiet and respectful during the show as our actors do not have mics and should not strain their voices. We'll be sending refreshments and snacks in the courtyard. Please make sure to throw away any garbage as we want to ensure the HHS auditorium remains pristine for future productions. Laugh openly and have fun. My cast and crew have diligently worked on this show with the help of our wonderful sponsor, Mr. Gainias. And we hope that you are as delighted in it as we are. Por favor, pueden apagar los teléfonos y no fotografía flash. Gracias. Thank you, and let the show begin.
Chicken leg.
Publix. Oh. But like also from like a chicken.
Listen, I know I fall in love quickly, but I fall out of love just as quickly.
I guess I can love you too.
Too late. Move on. Let's go, Sam!
Hey, who put you in charge anyways?
I think you're gonna prom with that buddy?
No. I was just wondering. Hey, is that girl single?
Yeah, I thought so. Let's go, Christy! I'm not gonna wait all night for you!
I'm hurt! I can't make it! Leave me behind!
Okay.
That's it?
Yeah. What?
You're just gonna leave me here?
That's what you told me to do!
I didn't mean it!
Then why did you say it?
I was hoping you would pick me up and carry me.
Of course.
You're not gonna pick me up?
You know, Christy, I want you to listen to me and listen to me closely. The fact that you're a good-sized meal means that the zombies come and get you. You're gonna keep them long enough, occupied long enough for us to get away. We'll remember you fondly. Before I go though, can I get a quick kiss?
I think my leg is feeling better. I can probably live there.
It's swollen. You should take some weight off of it.
No, I'm okay. I can walk.
No, sit down. Have a soda. Just wait for the end. It's so much easier.
No, Jimmy, I'm not going to do that. Let's go.
Fine. Ladies first. See, Christy?
Sit for this country. Sit for humanity. I want you to
for that girl you loved but never had the courage to say anything to.
Hey, Susan, can I talk to you for a second?
Shut up, Jamie! Nobody cares!
After the inspirational speech!
Fine. Now you're probably thinking to yourself, what can I do? One person against an army of unstoppable zombies. We've seen them. We know how many there are. A lot. I mean, so many zombies that they can literally climb over each other to go up skyscrapers. I don't need to tell all of you, that is a lot of zombies. And yes, we're likely to die horribly and rise up from the dead and join them in a tidal wave of nightmarish destruction that will sweep over the entire planet. That's a likely scenario. Hopefully, we won't feel too much pain. But we probably will. Like, you know when you go to the dentist? This is gonna be a lot worse than that. This is gonna be like a million dentists poking you at the same time. And I know what you're thinking. How will these dentists even reach me? But let's say they're tiny dentists, but their tiny needles hurt just as much as regular-sized needles. That's probably the same range in the amount of pain that we're gonna feel when the zombies are tearing us limb from limb! Where was I again?
You were giving an inspirational speech.
Right. Let me check my notes. Tiny dentists, lots of pain, zombies, fight them! That's right! We need to fight them!
And how are we gonna do that? There's just four of us!
And two of us are girls!
Now is not the time for sexism, Jimmy!
Listen, I'm not being sexist, but hey, can we talk for a second?
They're coming!
Guys, wait, I forgot! Remember that time we were hiding out of the Pentagon? I just happened to find a cache of experimental government weapons that no one ever knew about! Let's see!
A baseball bat?
We have this thermonuclear flash grenade.
I'm using this, guys. I love it.
Fusion rifle?
Guys, I played baseball in high school.
Shut up, Jimmy!
I am talking!
Fine! And we have an anti-gravity ion disruptor cannon. And you already got
that was Jimmy!
Now, weapons that they just decided not to tell us about and also decided do not fire, apparently.
Yeah, what are the odds of that happening?
Pretty slim, so you just might need another option. Method 4, join the zombies!
Guys, let's take a break here.
I can't scoot another inch. Get up, man! You know, why do you always have to be so mean?
Guys, we're running out of options.
I know, but he doesn't have to be so unpleasant all the time.
Unpleasant? Are you kidding me? I'm not the way we're doing french fries.
I asked you if you wanted some.
I did. I did want some.
And how was I supposed to know that, Jimmy? Body language?
Maybe you couldn't figure since I was starving to death that I was hungry.
You know, ever since this whole apocalypse thing started, you've been really, really rude.
Rude? Are you kidding me? Rude?
Hey, we're losing sight of what's important here. We still have our health.
No, Christine, I might have my health.
If I had some french fries! Oh, buddy, it doesn't look like you need any more french fries. Oh, is that the one? Is that the one where you turn into a werewolf?
No, it's lycanthropy. You obviously failed science.
Whatever, nerd.
Crap, I love zombie.
This is your fault, Sam.
Oh, it's my fault now.
Yeah, maybe you weren't here arguing with me.
We could have gotten away.
Are you sure?
You would have gotten away and slammed the door in my face.
I would have just to pop the stupid pimple on your forehead.
Shut up. I'm not perfect.
Such a drama nerd!
Trust me, Jimmy, if I don't like you, I know they're gonna like you. And besides, you can't have two girlfriends!
Yes, I can!
Hey, Susan, are you thinking you had, Mickey?
Yeah, Jimmy's father's really good for the sanctuary, right?
Yeah, you know, I thought Sam was cute, but he's actually really mean to me.
Bro, you know what? You are just jealous of my butt!
Me? I'm not for that flabby piece of flesh you call a butt!
Guys, that was way too close.
You're telling me They almost got my knees.
You're surprising the chipper for having your legs almost eaten off.
You know, Susan, you surprise yourself a little every day. You know, I could sit here and wish I had my feet back, but honestly, what's wishing gonna do for me?
You're taking this well, Sam.
Yeah, you know, I've been doing a lot of yoga lately.
Alright, yoga aside, they are still gaining on us. Do you, mind if we kinda just, you know, leave?
Yeah, I do mind, actually.
Really? I just thought, you know, since you're kind of slowing us down, you wouldn't care.
No, I'd like to be dragged to safety.
Thanks. Really? Why don't you just sacrifice yourself for the greater good of the rest of us?
Jimmy, you smell good.
Jimmy, come on!
Alright, buddy, I'll be happy to take you, but just know that your actions are probably gonna kill me, you know, Jimmy, probably Christy and Susan. How do you feel about that? Do you care? Drag away! Christy?
You know, I'd help Sam, but I have four eyes, like you said earlier.
Ooh, burn, buddy. Susan?
Yeah, I don't want to get the wrong idea. Huh.
Susan, who would ever be attracted to you?
Wait, who?
Cares!
Yeah. But anyway, if I drive you away, you're gonna think there's something going on between us, and that's a headache I just don't want to deal with right now.
Whatever, I don't want you touching me anyways. It's like it's just you and me, buddy.
Wait, you don't want her touching you, but you want me?
What?
Yeah, I'll take my chances. Bye!
And I'm not calling you, dick.
Fine. Genetically modified killer dogs. They're trained to attack and destroy zombies. Too bad my friends aren't here to benefit from their bone-crushing jaws, disease-resistant fur, and adorable puppy eyes. Oh crap. It's time to shine, guys. Barack Obama, Scooby-Doo, get him! Go!
Thank you.
made it, Susan! Guys! Guys, get behind me!
I got Susan!
Get behind me now! Don't worry! I know Kung Fu!
You exist in the subversion of my paradigm. And you You are my great white whale.
Not for what you must strive for.
Never.
Alright, that's a very rational assessment situation, right guys? Right, right?
Wait. If I eat you, I'd have no reason to exist.
That's true, yes. But, you see, I have a plan. I work on this guy. I prepare an entire presentation.
So,
one second. So, this is
actually a really
good place.
Watch it,
bud. Sam, you're ruining it. Okay.
Don't worry, you got yourself.
Okay. You obviously made the level two, because you can't even make the level four. I have a solution. We must build an organic farm.
Farm.
Oh, thank you.
Only scenario in which an English major would come in handy.
So, make sure to befriend one today, right? Even though they are pretty obnoxious and rude.
Yeah. Alright, so move on to our eighth method.
Romance the zombies!
Romance the zombies?
Okay. Yeah. When you say it like that, method eight, romance the zombies, it's not the most ideal method. I mean, if you've exhausted the other seven, then go ahead. What do you have to lose? But otherwise, I would recommend against method eight.
Again, method eight, not the best method.
But I mean, you all already paid. You're in here for the long run. It's almost over. Let's watch.
We're surrounding.
All right, guys. I have an idea, but it's so crazy that it might just work.
What is it?
First, we need to determine which one of us is the most attractive. Why?
All right,
shut up. Good.
I mean, I'm
repulsive.
Oh, I'm hideous. Yeah?
You are, but...
it's agreed. You're obviously a perfect specimen of human beauty, and the rest of us, we're nerds, would be likely to be mistaken for slugs. You're obviously the perfect candidate to do it.
Wait, to do what?
All right. Susan, now is not the time to be asking questions, all right? Now is the time to be trusting your friends and acting.
What?
All right, are you ready?
Ready to do what?
Romance them.
Oh!
looking at, you know, zombies are soulless, brainless killing machines.
Yeah. But you know, I think that that just proves something. Right, folks? Just proves that you don't need a brain, or soul, or even a proper shirt to fall in love, right?
So true.
Yeah. Anyway, it's time, folks. We left the best for last. Almost last, anyway. Method 9, run really fast!
Roxy!
Hurry up! No one cares about Roxy!
Ding!
That's it. No, no, that does not seem... No, you can't do that!
Okay, fine! For everybody who's never satisfied... Method 9! Don't fall down while you're running really fast!
Thank you.
same exact place we were just in.
Shut up, Sam! No one cares about your stupid opinion!
You're irrelevant! I'm 100, you're 0.
Why?
Ask for me!
Wait! Is this? It's the spaceship! Damn it!
Alright, genius, why don't you tell me how we're supposed to fit in that?
You know, I just had a wonderful idea. Why don't I cut you open and stick you inside of here? See? Leave! We don't like you! Go away!
So, what do we do now?
Bonus method 11, cannibalism.
What?
Guys, so I found this hot sauce in my bag.
Sad!
Where are you guys from? 2013?
Dodge of pop culture references.
I like Rick and Morty.
Yeah. And Sam, behind your pathetic exterior, I'm sure you have some valuable qualities. Deep in there somewhere. And I'm a girl. So I say, instead of resorting to cannibalism, let's resort to cannibalism.
All right. Let's hear first.
Hey! We've already established the journey. These are all stupid.
Now listen to me.
Huddle up.
Let's eat the narrators!
What?
Thank you.
entertain you guys. Our first meeting will be on
October 26th!
Take a picture of one of our